We're going to be going from all of these components to... So let me walk you through it. We have negative end over here wired to our relay. Also run into the negative side of our fuse block. Power out from the relay to the fuse block here. We've got power, main power, positive side coming into our relay and also running to our switch here. We're powered up here. We've got a fuse in line here to keep this safe. Then we have the output of the switch running to the switch side of the relay. So when we flip the switch here, we get an on indicator, and that turns the relay on. This pair of wires running into our box for the light, and this switch. I flip this switch, on with the light. First off, we're putting our switch plate in. This will have the on-off switch and some USB and 12 volt ports. Let's put this right here. So brilliant. So we actually want a hole to run the cord through. So we'll just mark a spot where we put that hole. Lastly, we're putting waterproof gland in here. We're running the solar power hookups. And that apparently didn't work. I'll mark a few holes here so that we can secure it on the outside. And we need a couple of holes for the wires to run through. We'll want a hole both for the mounting bolt and light cable. Mark a hole in the front here for the light. For all these holes, I'm taking a measurement of the size of hole I'll need, 5/8. I have a hole saw, 1 1/4 inch, which will be slightly larger than this 1 1/8 inch diameter holes that I need. What I do need to do is make sure I've got the center guide pilot hole in the center of these circles. So what I'm going to do, not quite precise, but Now that we have the holes drilled, it's time to start mounting the switches and panels. This is actually going to go inside the case. It has 4 screws to mount, but it also has a display and a button that we like to bring in. So I made a little template for the screen. So I'm going to put a couple of starter holes here in the corners. This is a coping saw, but it makes an excellent tool for doing this so that I can cut this way and this way. After cutting the hole and mounting the charge controller, here it is. I put the glands on the wrong side from the input because these will fold up and connect. I've added some heat shrink tubing on here to cover up these connectors. Thank you.